Hello to our fans online. I'm Rob Nelson.
And I'm Paula Ferris with the top stories on this Thursday. It is certain to be a highly emotional day for parents as Sandy Hook Elementary School students return to class for the first time since last month's shooting. Families, they got a chance yesterday to check out the building where classes will be held. It's been renovated to accommodate younger students. And the sign outside of Chalk Hill Middle School has been changed to read Sandy Hook Elementary School. And green ribbons of support line the road to the school.
After a firestorm of criticism, House Speaker John Boehner has agreed to hold a vote tomorrow on aid for victims of Hurricane Sandy. The new Congress being sworn in today will vote on a $9 billion portion of that bill, and a vote for the remaining $51 billion will be held on the 15th of the month. Both Republicans and Democrats from New York and New Jersey criticized Boehner for allowing Congress to adjourn after the fiscal cliff deal without voting on that storm aid package.
And Secretary of State Hillary Clinton back home in suburban New York following treatment for a blood clot. She was released from the hospital yesterday afternoon. A State Department spokesman says Clinton is anxious to get back to the office, but it is unclear when she will return to Washington.
Just rest, Hillary.
Yes,
take a little
please.
Break. And finally, five inmates in Idaho are suing major alcohol producers, saying alcohol use led to their crimes. Yep, those crimes include manslaughter and theft. Now, in their suit, they also say they should have been warned that the alcoholic beverage they were consuming can be addictive. They are now seeking $1 billion in damages from companies including Anheuser-Busch, Miller Brewing, the Gallo Winery, and also the makers of Jim Beam. No response yet from the companies.
Two things missing from our society: responsibility, owning up to it, and common sense.
Paula's take on the world. Mm-hmm. Let's all have another to think about the craziness of that story.
Huh? I will get off my soapbox now.
Soapbox?
My soapbox. Yeah, I can't speak.
We had a few drinks.
Ironically, no one warned us about the effects.
Stunned.
You can get more news anytime at abcnews.com. I'm Paula Ferris.
And I'm Rob Nelson. Thanks for watching.
This is World News Now, available anytime, anywhere you want it.